Morning! Greetings, everyone. This is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party. We're here at the Aqua Base. Made some changes. This is the Guardian XP farm, the little mini Guardian XP farm that we built before. It works! Got a tree down there. It's, I built a little bedroom. Or modified this little top cupola or whatever you want to call it. Go on! You can go down. There we go. Added some windows. So you can look out and see. And bed. Right? Storage room. Nothing new there. Added a little chanting setup. A little brewing stand over here. Still working on this. I want to do like a mini semi-automated sort of thing. This floor is still pretty much completely empty. And I decorated down here a bit. Ow! So I put grass and some flowers. So pretty. And tree. It's my tree farm. I got some carrots. So I grassed this all in. La-da-da-da. I put some bushes out here with lamps underneath. Sea lanterns underneath. So that it gets light. Because this is below the area where the only guardians will spawn. So you can get mobs down here. Which can be a little bit of a pain. Steps down here. I have to figure out what to do with some of this. Like this. This is kind of a waste. This is wasted space. This was cool when the whole area was underwater. I wouldn't mind. I mean, this is all I've got water under here. But I was hoping squids would spawn in here. But they don't. They changed something with the audio, I think. The audio is extremely directional now. And I don't know when that happened. I just noticed this morning when I put on headphones. I don't play with headphones normally. Oh, there was a big hill coming down here. So I kind of reconstructed what the ocean monument would look like if it had generated this far down instead of being all stone and stuff. So I have to decide what to do with this. I've got a mountain inside my underwater area. Which is kind of cool, but I may go clear it out. Don't know. Not important. I don't spend a lot of time out here. Tree farm. Interestingly, these giant spruce trees, you know how the dark oak tree leaves will replace blocks that they try to spawn into? That's how the bedrock trick worked back when it did. These leaves do not. They go up and they will not spawn where the glass is, so get fewer leaves with the tree right there. But I get plenty of wood, which is important. These torches mark out a slime chunk. And the slimes can spawn up to level 40. We're at like where are we at? We're at Y32 here. So the slimes will actually spawn up a little bit. And so I occasionally get slimes in here. Not sure how to deal with that. Because they can come up over here and trample my carrots. Which I don't want. But they're mostly harmless. Guardian farm works. I think I showed that last time. Anyway. Got one other thing. Oh, hey, dude. Yeah, I got my string. Notice how mob sounds are either on the right or on the left. And there's like no in between. Hey, dude, where are you going? Sounds so weird. Yeah, having the strength 2 beacon is nice because then when those guys come up, because this is actually a little miniature gold farm, when those guys come up, I can I don't have to worry about angering them and letting them go back through the portal. Anyway, how are you? I'm doing all right. I'm homesick today, so I have a little time to record. I've been busy, just general life stuff. I think this is new. I kind of decorated out this little storage area underground here by my mining area. Mines. This goes out into caverns. I have a little lava farm here. Not really a farm, but you know. So I've got all this lit up. Stairway up to the upper levels of this little ravine here. Let's see. What's going on? Yeah, I'm homesick today. I ate something over the July 4th weekend that I should not have. So I'm kind of playing. Was that a bat? That must have been a bat. Wow. So I've been playing food allergy or food poisoning. At this point, I'm not sure which one's winning. So I've been doing a little mine, you know, branch mining down here. Just, I've gotten a little, I don't know. I don't want to say bored, but I'm lacking inspiration these last couple weeks. And I've been branch mining and came down here. And I noticed I was getting a lot of slimes right around in here. So I did a little research. Bam! 4 slime chunks. Contiguous. Of course, there's nothing here right now. That would have been too convenient. It would have been too dramatic for the video. Anyway, so I'm building a little slime farm to take advantage of this. This should look somewhat familiar. It's like a larger version of the slime farm I built over under Vex's place. We're down pretty far down here. We're at like Y6. So, can't go down too much farther. I need to be able to go down 2 for the hopper chain to feed over here. And I've been putting in the packed ice. The hopper chain comes over here. Oh, 28 slime. And so I've got a couple platforms. I've got a nice little thing here. Goes up. I've been building up. Be able to build up actually past where the ocean top is, which is going to be interesting because I want to build this thing up as tall as I can. There's no reason. We're in the ocean right now. Biome. Beach. Oh, we're under beach. That might be a problem. Okay, so this might become an issue of big enough, which is fine. I don't care. So I've got a few caverns up here, which I had already gone through and lit up because I was hearing miscellaneous zombie noises. So I've got a couple spawning platforms here. They're too thick. This is all the same as the other one. I made them 2 blocks thick so I could put lights underneath here. Set of glowstone lamps, or a glowstone. I'm using sea lanterns because we're close to the sea land. We're close to the guardian farm, so I've got all the blocks that I want. And so I'm laying in the packed ice now, and this will be cool. I kind of built this up in a creative world. Let me show that to you, and you can see kind of how it's going to work. Because it should work pretty well. I shouldn't have to do much. And we're pretty close to the base itself. So I think this guy's off my bar. Munch, 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 munch. What's my sword doing? Okay, it's doing fine. So I've got some building supplies here. It's close enough to the base that I think so at least partially be active when I'm just running around, certainly when I'm mining. So let me show you that. Hang on a sec. All right, so here's the slime farmer. Here's the scale model, 1-to-1 scale model of the slime farm. Kind of, it's actually, the dimensions are working out a little differently, but that's okay. So this is what it's going to look like. Let me pop down here. Ooh. So here's the center part. Lots of water. So I've got, in order to make the water flow all along these 3 chunks here, 2.5 chunks, pop, 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 I have to terrace it down. Bang, bang, bang. I suppose I don't have to, but this is, I think, going to work better. The slimes, the big slimes especially, can swim against the current, even on top of packed ice. So that's not so awesome. So anyway, this is kind of what I'm building. So this is like 5 layers, 5 terraces down. This side only has 2. Pop, pop. and it pushes them down into these cacti ring with a hopper chain around them. Leads out to a chest over here. I've got water recessed back underneath the wall here in order to flow onto, push them onto this side here and this side. Recessed so that I could put an extra block here and get prevent all this water from becoming a source block, right? And then this pushes them off that block. So there we go. And so we just take advantage of the fact that the slimes are stupid and they move kind of randomly unless they're targeting a player, and then they will eventually jump off these platforms and down into the water. And see, the big ones are able to, they're able to keep up, so eventually they turn around and swim downstream towards the cactuses, which kills them. Takes a while, but it works. See, they just choose a random direction and try to move in it. And if their random direction is directly against the current, the big ones can make it. But eventually they turn. And it pushes them into the cactus. Everything works. So, I wanted to do this just to get a sense of scale. I should probably put a hole in that wall. And then all the slime balls come in here. Won't be as quick as manually killing them with the looting sword, but that's not the point. Stupid rain and thunder. Okay, so anyway, that's that. Do I have anything else here to show you? I built something. Oh, yeah. I wanted to see, I didn't end up using this, but I wanted to see if the if hopper minecarts would pick up items underneath in flowing water through packed ice. And guess what? They do. So that's actually a bit of a possibility. Not going to use it in this case because don't really have a way to. They do have to be picked up by the hoppers. They have to be picked up by the hoppers around the cacti, but that's enough. Anyway, so I was just playing around with this. So this is what we're going to be doing. All right, let's see. I have another little thing to show you real quick, and I'll be right back. Spooky sounds. I need to brew some more fire resistance potions for here. So I'm at the I am at the Nether Fortress. Let me go ahead and drink one of these. I'm going to need it. All right. And let me kill this guy because I need some more Magna Cream to make more fire resistance potions. Yeah, awesome. Oh. Hey. Killing these guys here, what do you think you're doing? Oh, hello. So, let me, oops. Oh, that was really embarrassing. All right. Hey. Oh, that didn't kill you, mister. Oh, you're wearing armor. Hi. You can give me a head? No, not quite. Hi. You can give me a head? Nope. Okay. Oh, Hey, dude. Hey, you. Yeah, you. Oh, that was annoying. Hey, that wasn't very nice. Oh, okay. Goodness, it's dangerous in here. All right. So this is the Nether fortress. Our wither skeleton farm. Works actually reasonably well. We get enough wither skeleton spawns. It works pretty well. The biggest danger is whacking one of the piggies accidentally. But that's why I grabbed a strength potion. But I don't know if I ever showed this. But we have a blaze spawner right up here. So I've done a little work on that, digging out the area that they spawn in and putting in some lights. So the cool thing is, I do that. Oh, guess what? I get spawn. I get blazes immediately. And they spawn pretty continuously until you turn the lights back on. So these lights are just enough to keep these guys from spawning. They have a pretty high spawn light condition. So I want to turn this into a farm of some sort so we can get the blaze rods, because they're useful. They're a nice fuel supply, especially here in the Nether. Although, you certainly get enough coal from the wither skeletons. Okay. So anyway, I think that's all I wanted to show you. Got a nice little short episode here. Just a little catch up. Haven't been really working on any projects here. Mostly just been tooling around, doing some branch mining, trying to get things established at the Aqua Base, which is nice and conveniently located. Hey. These guys are a good source of XP too. Oh, what have we got over here? Hey. Hey, I'm trying to do something here. And cool. Anyway. So, another fortress. I did slab out a lot of this. Went through and just put nether brick slabs everywhere to try and concentrate the spawning down into the fortress itself here. Oh, that is never going to stop, is it? How'd that even get started? Ah, must be old. Never mind. So, slabbing up here, getting some over there. It's another thing. When I have a little bit of time, I should go slab all this as well. Hi, Mr. Bl Whoa. Oh, that's right. The fortress continues down there. And this is fortress up there too, and I'm not sure whether I should just slab that or tear it down or what. I don't know. Don't really have a big project planned. Just kind of tooling around mostly, and we'll figure it out. There we go. Let's grab some angry geomints here while we're at it. Magma cream. And some redstone. And how are we doing here? Water bottle. So I can do this and then this and then this. And make myself some more fire resistance potions. Very good. Anyway, that's all I got. Not super exciting. Broken stone swords and zombie flesh and arrows. Don't really need all this stuff. But there you have it. 52, now you got 55. All right. So I want to restock the potion chest before I go. Let's see, anything else? I don't think so. Minecon happened last weekend. Looked like it was very cool. Lots of great panels. Fortunately, most of them got broadcast on YouTube or on Twitch, and then I was able to, you can watch them after the fact. So that's very cool. So you didn't even need to go. I was wanting to go, but the airfares. Oh, what am I doing? Airfares to London. Very expensive. Especially over that time frame, because I guess it's sort of peak tourist season. Hey, come on. I hope they fix that. And it's raining. It's raining. All right. So just getting to London for me and my wife would have been thousands of dollars, and I think I'd rather spend that on a vacation which we can both fully enjoy. So we're talking about doing something in the fall. Maybe going to Hawaii. It's been a long time since I've been to Hawaii, and when I went, I was working and didn't really get to spend much time enjoying the islands, doing the touristy thing. So we will, we may do that. My wife spent some time as a child growing up in Hawaii. Her father was working for the Navy as a civilian employee, being a fire chief. So she's got, doesn't have family there, but has memories. So we may go enjoy that. And that'd be a nice little vacation. But I don't... Ah, hello, Mr. Slime. See, they do spawn there. So I need to get this water in and then build the rest of the spawning platforms. I don't know how many up I'm going to go. Here, I think we're underwater, right? Biome, deep ocean. So I have to see. I know that this, when I put in this beacon, I put in a haste 2 beacon here. This goes up to beach and actually kind of goes up next just a few blocks away from actual beach. So, yeah, I have to sort of scout out and see what the situation like this is up on the surface and see whether that will work or not. So, let's see. Thoughts on Minecon? I'm sad I didn't get to go. I would have liked to have seen some of the stuff that they were showing, especially the HoloLens. I am a little bit dismayed about the Windows 10 Minecraft. Hey, dude. You're in my way. I hope that doesn't become Microsoft's idea of the premier version of Minecraft. I guess I'm a little bit... As you can just see just there, I am on a Macintosh. Because I like actually being able to use my computer. But it's based on Pocket Edition, so it looks like it'll bring parity with the Xbox version, which is fine. But I would hate for them to put all of their development efforts into the Windows 10 version, which is clearly not Java-based. It's probably .NET or something, which means it probably has all sorts of interesting issues that people will figure out once they start playing it. But I'm not going to start. I'm not going to get a Windows machine just so I can play Minecraft. I say that now, but we'll see what happens. So that's and I imagine that the Windows 10 version was developed by Microsoft developers in Washington, as opposed to the 1.9 development that's happening in Sweden with the Mojang crew. So I'm glad to see some more details on 1.9. I was hoping they were going to announce that they would start releasing development snapshots of 1.9 at Minecon, which they did not. Sorry, telephone ringing. Somebody calling from a cell phone. Doesn't know us. Because if they did, they would know that we never answer the phone. All right. So anyway, I'm going to keep working on this. I don't know that you need to watch. Not super exciting. So I am interested in seeing where 1.9 goes. It's I like the changes they're making to the end from the looks of it. I am eager to give it a try. Not on server here. We will wait until 1.9 gets officially released. My one question is that all the changes to the end, are they going to require a reset of the server, or will they be able to generate into an existing end island? Because we've got a lot of building going on here. I'm not super eager to do a server reset, but you know, we will see. Maybe there's some my MC edit chicanery that can go on to help create or delete the end. Although I don't really want to get rid of the XP farm. Although I have ideas for how to improve it. I certainly could build one of those Endermite powered Enderman farms from the DocM77 and the Zip Crowd came up with, because they work really fast. And I was already halfway into building ours before they released the video. So I was kind of committed. So there we go. All right. So the only question here is, should I put in the water or not while I'm working on the rest of it? Nice thing about having the water in place is that any blocks that drop will get picked up in my chest. That's something. And I don't need these torches down. Torches are only here to keep skeletons and zombies and such from spawning. Let's see, lift this up. Oops. I need 3 clearance from here, so I need to lift that up one more. Oh, you know what? Actually, I need 3 clearance from here. I need 3 clearance under here, so this needs to come up one more, but it can be at that height. This is at the right height, so I can start building these platforms. And I need more blocks to do that. Hi, dude. Let's see what we got in the chest here now. And I don't want this to be a chest. I want this to be an item elevator. Ooh, 4 slime. Item elevator lifted up into here. I'll decorate out this room. The beacon will go away when I'm done. When I'm done tearing stuff out. But I mean, this, you know, I'm getting lots of slime just from working in here. So anyway, Yeah, I need to decide what to do. Spend a lot of time in here. Just. Oh! I hear a zombie! Where's that zombie come from? Oh! I don't necessarily want to turn to the wall that far. Huh. Okay. Okay, well. Not really important. So I'm gonna keep working on this, get some water so I can recuperate from this whatever. Food poisoning or food allergy response, whatever. My suspicion is he made some potato salad for the fourth, which was yummy, but I don't think it sat too well with me. So, anyway, I got caverns over here, so that zombie is probably I've probably got some unlit caverns up in this area that I need to sort out. I love instant mine. So, anyway, I'm gonna continue working on this and put on some movies or something. And I will see you next time. All right, bye.